Once upon a time, there was a species of aliens from the moon which circled the planet Earth. These aliens had big heads and small skinny legs. They used to drive fast cars and make big bucks in the entertainment. These little aliens had names like Jim, John, James, and Frank, and Walter, Smith, and Jones. They used to visit planet Earth and kidnap babes, sweet hot chickadees with long legs and blonde hair and lipstick and handbags and high heels and mini skirts, and take them back to the moon to make space babies. Well, these space babes love these little alien dudes because of their big heads and small skinny legs. And they used to dress up in sexy lingerie on their wedding nights, and every little space baby was sent back to Earth to work. And that's how planet Earth came to be, full of these creatures we know called humans, who are really just hybrids, a cross between monkeys and aliens and space babes and all the rest of it, yeah. And that's how I came to be a famous novelist. I was informed of the space babies by aliens from Mars, rivals on a local talent show, who wanted to scout out fresh ability in writing skills and notation by music students on planet Earth.
See you.
the stars fall out of the sky. They fall into my bedroom. Once upon a time, I was the ruler of a great and famous nation. My subjects loved and obeyed me. This precious stone, whose smiling edges cut into my guts. For millions of years it lay there, distilled through Noah's tears. Each tear poured into my body, neat as whiskey. For centuries, I struggled to remove it. its worth and the riches it would fetch if I could pawn it. I was proud of my jewel heart. I killed many dragons. Their wormy coats became ornaments on my throne. In the end, the jewel was my ruin. I mined and quarried deep into the flesh and bone. The searing pain convinced me of my courage. And so, the jewel fell into my eager hands. Through failing fingers, I saw it was as I had all along suspected, and I was happy on the moment that I died.
God's wife was a real bitch. One day he threw her out.
started her own army, sued for divorce, and took half the kingdom of heaven. Bitch. She was called Lucy. A witch put a spell on me. She used to practice black magic behind the curtains during surgery hours. Magic pills enchanted me. I can't seem to break free, twisting and beating my breast, frown lines on my brow, and careless stupid previews of Sumerian cuneiform script. Philosophy Book of Songs. Get my name bit. TM in lights. Face train. Copyright TM 120,111. Explain nation worldly tunes. A catchy sum it all up in a rhyme explanation. Thank you. sin. Send it away. Send it away. Send it to the other side of the world. Send it out into space and blow it to pieces. Send it to hell. Banish it. Imprison it. Send it away. Sin.
I will go to your brother.
No, not my brother. I wouldn't wish it on my worst enemy, not to mention my brother. Send it away. Where? There is no place far enough away to send it to. It will do evil wherever it goes. I cannot carry it. It is too much of a burden. It is too much responsibility. Send it away. No, not my little brother. I love him. I wouldn't wish it on him. I will keep it. I will find a way. I will carry it. It is mine. I will keep it. Out of love for my brothers, I will keep it so that they do not have to bear it. Wash it away. There's a word I'm searching for. It isn't love. It isn't hurt. I'm wounded. From the very start, a bullet ricochets off my heart. Cured by a bullet called love. Cured by a bullet called love. There's a song with many words, a melody. Cured by a bullet called love. Cured by a bullet called love. Thank you. who ring the bells. Heaven, hell, so far apart. A bullet ricochets off my heart. Cured by a bullet called love. Cured by a bullet.